extra hit a week.
That's what it comes down to. Where it could have gone way up.
Game and a player's performance. Not only is a player's resume defined by minuscule numeric differences, but those numbers can also get inside their heads and affect them. Let me show you.
What's your favorite number between 0 and 9?
Statistically,
it's just popping my head.
It's like numbers.
When asked, our brains immediately begin comparing numbers, looking for what seems to be the most exotic. Most of us eliminate the even numbers because of their easy divisibility. Of the remaining 5 digits, we lock on to the prime numbers that are only divisible by 1 and themselves. 3, though, seems too common. 3 lights at a stoplight, 3 meals a day. We discount the 5 because it's right in the middle, so that leaves 7.
7.
7, all right. It's an example of how our brains perceive numbers without us really realizing it. The same psychology is at work in baseball.
So numbers can actually be a huge distraction and a detriment to being a good player.
Yeah, they really do. They start piling up on you, especially if you get out of the gates real slow. You start what we call digging the hole, and then you have to try to climb out of that. So then you have to pick up your numbers to get back on an even pace that most players are on.
That's why a lot of players adopt rituals, superstitions they believe will help them from digging any holes. Some will eat the same meal before a game. Some will change their socks, or they'll take something out on the field with them.
Can you give me an example of a couple of superstitions that you've seen in your days?
What happened, man?
Hi, Jenny.
Look at Jerry. He's so cute.
Jerry?
Who believes numbers exert an invisible power over the world?
Personalities and characteristics are like little entities that are having an influence on our lives. Become more aware of the influence that they have on us.
According to Camber,
Jeffers
told me about the cesium.
What is it, man?
The resonant frequency of the cesium atom is 9,132,631,770 cycles per second.
Just like atoms, each number has a unique frequency. Those frequencies are what Camber believes helps influence and steer events in the everyday world. Camber's actually not the first person to think this. The ancient mathematician Pythagoras thought numbers were imbued with certain divine powers.
What happened, Chubby? Look at her.
Then there was Plato. He believed a whole universe of numbers and pure mathematics existed outside of ours.
Hi, Chubby.
So I think I understand that. It's the numbers we read, the ones we speak, and even write. They're the numbers we see on cars, in advertisements, street signs,
and addresses. Milk.
The way Camber sees it, they're all at work exerting an unseen force over the world.
So let's take an example where something traumatic happened to us here in the United States. So 9/11/2001. So now what we have to do with numerology, the compulsivity. It could also be dark and nasty and unforgiving. But then you have the 9 and the 11 added together, equals, ends up with a single digit of a 2. So the 2 is where we're transforming ourselves from one particular reality to a brand new reality. We were all transformed in that day. You and I don't live in the same world that we lived in before then.
There's actually a name for it, triskaidekaphobia.
The symbol gives us the ability to have something to focus on. But beyond the symbol is this whole personality. It's this whole world whirling around each one of these numbers. And all of us are surrounded by it every day, but you know, most of us don't realize the impact and the influence that numbers are having on us.
I set out on this journey to reveal the truth about numbers. Do they really have powers we don't fully understand? What I found out blew me away. We live in a universe of numbers. They're everywhere. Some of them are right in front of us.
Lay down there, Chubby. Your mama is certainly not in the mood to play now. They have their own spot.